Christine Ueno has more on our top story.
Joe, although there were a few challenges with this project, it was completed on time, and the state and beachgoers are happy with the results.
Laura Young and her daughter spent the last night of their Hawaiian vacation at Waikiki Beach.
And my youngest especially, that's kind of one of the things, one of the only things she wanted to do was go to the beach.
And like many visitors,
been here almost every day.
That's why the state recognizes its importance.
One study was indicating that loss of the beach could result in as much as a $200 million loss in revenues to the state annually.
So for the past 4 months, crews worked to widen and elevate about 1,700 feet of the iconic beach. In some areas, there's now up to 40 feet of new sand.
With the grade now at a nice slope like this, it's perfect for us. When it was steep, it was a little dangerous for the tourists.
Crews did have a few challenges. For example, maintaining the high quality of water and switching from a sand pumping process to a truck haul process.
So the truck haul process was challenging because we're dealing with large articulated dump trucks and thousands of people, and so it all had to be orchestrated very carefully.
The worst part was the process. The aftermath is pretty good.
And that's what's most significant, to keep this symbol of Hawaii appealing to beachgoers and leave them wanting more.
This was such a good experience. I would definitely come back and try it again.
State officials say it's important to maintain one of Hawaii's icons, so they might restore Waikiki Beach again in 7 years. Christine Ueno, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.